One night, as he sat head in hands, trembling from head to foot, a man appeared to him and said, "I've been sent by, and here he named the dear name, to comfort you." Then drawing a worn volume from the pocket of his own black coat, he sat and read till dawn, then disappeared without a word. Sometime later, he appeared again, with the same volume, at the same hour, and this time without preamble, he sat and read it through again in the long night through, then disappeared without a word. This text is taken out from Beckett's play, Ohio Impromptu. Why am I quoting this text? Because I believe that any work of art can be taken and transformed into a classroom activity for the purposes of creative education. And I adore this play because it has inspired me in many ways. First, I want to comment on the relationship between teacher and student. For example, this text made me think of the teacher as Beckett's reader, while the student as Beckett's listener. But this is not the traditional approach of passive reader and passive and active listener, but rather the roles of the teacher and the student now constantly interchange. And as the text suggests, the teacher guides the student and then disappears without a word, while then the student can think and act creatively and independently. And then another thing is that I have designed an activity for classroom purposes that involves a reader, a listener, and the audience. And I have so far tried it with fifth graders, with teenagers, and university students, and also with adults, and it has worked really good. And I've used it to teach vocabulary, grammar, and also to lighten up the gap-filling exercises. So why should the teacher experiment thus? Because if you want your students to think creatively, you also need to experiment and do the same. So I'd really like to share this activity and some other activities based on artistic works with all the other teachers. So thank you.